Class 9 children, welcome to today's online class. So in my previous video, I taught you the four conditions for the congruency of two triangles. So I showed you how to prove that the two triangles are congruent. So based on those theorem or those congruency theorem, today I will teach you one very important question here. So my question is here. A triangle ABC has angle B equal to angle C. So this is a triangle ABC. In this triangle ABC, angle B is equal to angle C. Very simple. Now next, prove that the perpendicular from the midpoint of BC and it is perpendicular to AB and AC are equal. So from the midpoint of BC, so who is the midpoint of BC? D. So from point D, the two perpendiculars, perpendicular to AB, so perpendicular to AB is DL and perpendicular to AC is DM. You can see DL is perpendicular to AB and DM is perpendicular to AC. So these two perpendicular lines are equal. That means you have to prove that DL is equal to DM. So question is very short, but from this you have to understand the meaning of the question, what they want to say. So let us begin here. My solution starts. Given in triangle ABC, in this triangle ABC, angle B is equal to angle C. It is given. Next, what is given? It is given that DL, that is DL, is perpendicular. Perpendicular. So DL is perpendicular to AB. And next one is DM is perpendicular to AC. So all the given thing I wrote. So next one, what we will write? To prove. So what do we have to prove? So to prove is, we have to prove that these two perpendiculars are equal. That is DL is equal to DM. So now we have to prove this. So to prove this, we will take these two small triangles. If you take these two small triangles, we can prove DL is equal to DM. So we write proof. That means we will start the proving part. So in proof, what you write? In triangle table. So let me write BDL, alphabetical way. BDL and triangle CDM or DCM, whatever. DCM. So in this two triangle, you have to understand this is 90 degree as per the perpendicular means, the perpendicular word means there is 90 degree here. So when these two lines are perpendicular, that means there is 90 degree here. So you can write since DL is perpendicular to AB, I am repeating the same, and DM is perpendicular to AC. So when they are perpendicular, we can say the two angles are equal. That is DLB, angle DLB will be equal to angle DMC, angle DMC. So DLB is equal to DMC, that means both are 90 degree. So you can write both are equal because both are 90 degree. Why they are 90 degree? Because DL is perpendicular to AB. DL is perpendicular to AB means here there is 90 degree. And DM is perpendicular to AC. DM is perpendicular to AC means here there is 90 degree. So both are 90 degree. That's why both are equal. First one we have proved. Now second, you read in the question that from the midpoint of BC, from the midpoint of BC means D is the midpoint of BC. So now when if it is a midpoint, that means these two sides will be equal. Why? Because suppose if it is 6 centimeter, BC is 6 centimeter, and if it is midpoint, what will happen? This will be 3, this will be 3. That means both the sides will be equal. BD will be equal to CD because D is the midpoint. So you have to write since D is midpoint. D is midpoint of whom? BC. So when it is a midpoint, we can say therefore BD will be equal to CD. Very easy. If it is a midpoint, then BD will be equal to CD. So now you can see we have proved one angle equal, one side equal. So one more thing we have to prove, then the triangle will be congruent. So what is the last thing to prove? Already it is given, angle B is equal to angle C, it is given, you see. So now this angle B is equal to angle C. So you can write, therefore, lack of space, so I am coming here. Therefore, or since angle LBD is equal to angle MCD, both are equal, it is given in the question itself. So here when they are given, that means we can say angle B is equal to angle C. You can see angle B is in the middle, angle C is in the middle. So now we can see that I have proved three things of this triangle are equal. One is angle, first one is angle, you can check 90 degree. Second one, BD is equal to CD. BD, these two sides are equal. And third one, these two angles are equal. So that means I can say by angle axiom, two angle and one side, two angle, first angle, second angle, first angle, second angle, so two angle, and these two sides are equal. So that way we can say therefore triangle BDL, this triangle BDL is congruent to triangle DMC, this one DMC. So both are congruent by angle side axiom. So by angle side axiom we can say they are congruent. Now when these two triangles are congruent, the other remaining angles also will be equal, other remaining sides also will be equal. So the other remaining side is DL equal to DM. Therefore now we have to prove that DL is equal to DM. So now we can say DL is equal to DM. So it is proved by CPCT. CPCT means corresponding parts of congruent triangle. So when these two triangles are congruent, automatically the remaining angles and the remaining sides also will be equal. So we could prove these two triangles are congruent. That's why the remaining parts, that is DL, also will be equal to DM. And this way we could prove that DL is equal to DM. Thank you, children.